Zonulin. What nutrients to look at if it's high?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Matthew, are you there?
Hey, Chris. How are you?
Hey, Matthew. I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Good. Want to ask you a quick question. I put it in the Q&A, so you know, go ahead and ignore it when you come across it. If it's too broad of a question, let me know. My wife just took the Zoomer test with Vibrant, and she took the Genova Ion 40. There's obviously a ton of information to go through, but one of the things
Is that Zonulin?
Regarding that question. It was with it was a stool and urine test with Vibrant Wellness Labs, I believe.
Okay.
So one of the things that stood out was that her number was on their, you know, chart was very, very high regarding Zonulin.
Oh, Zonulin?
Yeah, it was like 360 something. I don't remember how it was measured, but it was considered like way above their upper limit. And again, if this is too broad, then let me know. I was just curious if you had come across that. Obviously, there's a lot of information on the ion panel that you would probably go through and all of that. I'm not really familiar with Zonulin. Couldn't find much regarding Zonulin, but if you would come across that, would there be any other biomarkers particularly that you would be looking for if something like Zonulin was that high?
I think this question is better for someone like Chris Kresser, someone who works on gut health, because I kind of have placed gut health out of my primary expertise circle. But I'll answer your question anyway. Just take it with a grain of salt.
Okay.
So I understand Zonulin as a marker of intestinal permeability. And I looked into Zonulin way back in the day when some people in the paleo community were talking about, Alessandro, someone from Italy was doing research on gluten and Zonulin. I haven't looked into Zonulin since then, which was like 10 years ago. I would be looking at anything else that could explain intestinal inflammation. So if I think of that from from my perspective, which is much more focused on nutrients and biochemistry, then I'm thinking, and especially if you have the ion panel, which kind of takes apart my end of the spectrum, on the ion panel, actually, I would look at arachidonic acid levels because arachidonic acid in the gut is in the gut associated lymphoid tissue is metabolized to prostaglandin E2, which promotes immune tolerance. But on top of that, arachidonic acid production of PGE2 is also what forms all the junctions between the cells in the gut. And so if you have and I would look at the EPA to arachidonic acid ratio as well. Ion panel doesn't have a ratio, but as a substitute for a ratio, I would look at the relative position in the range of the two of those. So for example, if EPA is on the high end of the range and arachidonic acid is on the low end of the range, if they had a ratio, the ratio would probably be high for EPA to AA. Because EPA inhibits the conversion of arachidonic acid to prostaglandin E2. The other nutritionally modifiable factor promoting immune tolerance in the gut is retinoic acid. So I would look at vitamin A that's also on the ion panel. I kind of doubt that it would be useful to look at glutamine levels, but if they're off, it might provide some kind of clue of something, since glutamine is generally used by the gut to repair gut damage. And so I'm not sure if that's really going to correlate systemically with the plasma glutamine level. But if the plasma glutamine level is flagged as low, then I would probably, you know, further investigate that as a potential factor in the inability to repair damage in the gut. And then let's see what else is there. Well, there's a bunch of microbial markers on the ion panel that might, you might just want to look at that section to see if there's any indication of dysbiosis. I'm not so sure the gut markers on the ion panel are the best way to approach dysbiosis, but you know, if there are high markers of dysbiosis, you might want to more intensely follow up on the gut microbiome as a potential cause of the zonulin. Because obviously, if you have an inflammatory mix of microbes in the gut, you're going to get more inflammation there. But that's just me sort of brainstorming, and that's kind of the limit of my brainstorming right now.
Yeah, no, fair enough. And you're basically saying that if the zonulin levels were reading high, the vitamin A should be low potentially on that panel?
Potentially. Yeah. I mean, I'm not suggesting that that's probably the case. I'm just saying that the cascade of cause and effect events would be, if the vitamin A is low, that could be compromising tolerance to food antigens,
okay,
which could lead to an inflammatory reaction that creates some level of damage and decreased or increased permeability in the gut. So that's one potential out of many cascade of events that could drive that.
Okay, got it. Yeah, the zonulin thing was interesting because we've been figuring out what we think is probably some form of leaky gut, but SIBO and methane tests all come back negative. So we're dealing with, you hit the nail on the head, a lot of inflammatory gut-related things. There were obviously plenty of other markers that stood out, but that was the one that was on their, on their panel, at least, very, very high, and they marked it as a concern. So I was just curious your take on it from your perspective. So thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for your question, Matt. It was great talking to you.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The MasterPass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, the Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.